Here's a quick update on our weather. We don't have a whole lot going on, and that really speaks for itself here in the weather map here. Let's take a look at the lower 48, southern Canada, most of North America here. We've got all this cold air bottled up over Canada here. We're really not seeing any major cold air outbreaks. We are seeing 30s across the Great Lakes, but that's mainly normal for this time of year. We finally had a cold front come through that actually brought some normal temperatures, but we're going to see a slow warming trend. And out west, this is a very zonal flow. It's going to keep precipitation from piling up in any given area. So, that said, we have some frost and freeze advisories from northern Georgia over northern Alabama, northern Mississippi, northern Louisiana towards Shreveport, over towards northern Texas here, where temperatures could dip down into the 30s and upper 20s in some areas tonight. But other than that, we've got a few showers out on Cape Cod. That's about it. A few showers up here in the northwest. Things are staying kind of mild up here in the 50s and 60s for California for the most part. Lower 70s towards Los Angeles. Up in the northeast, that's where we've got a kind of a chilly, cold day. Let's take a look at precipitation amounts during the next 5 days. We're going to expect probably a quarter to half an inch across the northeast. Most of that has already fallen with last night's front. And we got some precipitation down here along the Carolina coast. Most of that will be offshore, maybe up to an inch in the Carolinas. Here in the northwest, we're going to see some areas developing up here in the northwest, up to an inch possible, mainly off the coast though. Maybe towards Seattle, we'll see up to an inch. Portland, probably about 3/4 of an inch during the next several days. As far as anything else to do with weather, we have this very zonal pattern here. You can see the 500 millibar heights. Right now, very zonal. We have a little bit of a trough in the Great Lakes. And this pattern doesn't change a whole lot if we go out 144 hours here. You can see things really... We have a hint here on the ECMWF of a trough developing and a possible coastal low. I'm sure many news and media outlets have probably said something about that. But as of right now, I am kind of shying away from saying anything about it because... last time the models did not do a very good job at the nor'easter, which was Athena, for the northeast. So, needless to say, I'm a little bit skeptical of what the ECMWF is saying. It's a very good model. It was dealt well with Sandy, but needless to say, I need more proof before I would go and say that there's going to be a major coastal storm. In fact, the ECMWF isn't even really tracking the system very close to the northeast now anyways either. The GFS takes it way off. You can see the GFS way out here, way out to sea, so not much to say there. The North Atlantic Index, North Atlantic Oscillation Index, we're well above, we're pushing one now. We're supposed to possibly go up between 1 and 2. But now there's some models saying here, like take a look at this, saying that the NAO index is going to actually fall below 0 again. And we'll see. If it goes negative, then we'll see a big threat of a nor'easter possibly next week. But as of right now, this pattern, let's bring up 500 millibars again. Look at this zonal pattern. When you see the height lines, height contours, this straight across, I mean systems are just going to zoom across the... Northern Tier states and not really stop and strengthen and drop much precipitation. Let's take a look at the scenario that I look at in this type of situation. I usually look for most of the areas that will see snow in this type of a situation will be the northern plains and northern Rockies. This is what we call the Colorado low setup, where we have the Colorado low develop in the vicinity of either Colorado, New Mexico, the Texas Panhandle, or Kansas, and then it strengthens as it heads northeast towards, say, the upper Mississippi Valley or the northern plains here, and then tracks towards either Lake Michigan or Lake Superior and drags all this warm air up further east and produces a big rainstorm along the east coast. And it doesn't have chance to develop a secondary low pressure and bring down cold air in a nor'easter. So this is the setup I'm looking for. The areas that will probably see above normal snowfall during the next several weeks will probably be the northern plains here in the northern Rockies, and above normal precipitation across the southern plains here. And across the northeast and the east coast, I'm looking for above normal temperatures and below normal precipitation. I'm meteorologist Mark Molnar. Like us on Facebook at MeteoMark. And here's a 4-day forecast for the rest of my viewing area from Binghamton to Elmira, and just north of Scranton in Pennsylvania.